everyone, welcome back to Keys to Chinese. This is Savannah. If you're watching this video, I'm sure you're a dedicated Chinese learner and want to practice and improve your Chinese every day. As language learners, we all want to avoid mistakes. In this video, I'm going to show you 6 most common mistakes Chinese learners make. Don't forget to check out the timeline in the description that you can jump to the parts that suit your learning needs. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and join our community. After watching this video, you will become more confident and comfortable when you speak Chinese. Mistake number 1, using adverbs without verbs. This mistake occurs a lot when we want to say me too. But in Chinese, when we say me too, we have to include the verb. For example, your friend says, 我想吃火锅. You say, 我也想吃. A lot of Chinese learners made this mistake by saying 我也. This mistake simply comes from the direct translation. When we say me too, that is literally 我也. But in Chinese, we have to include the actual verb. In this case, the actual verb is 想吃火锅. Since 火锅, the object has already established, we can omit the object. So we can just say 我也想吃. Mistake number 2, using 是 before an adjective. When we want to use an adjective to describe a subject, for example, America is very big. But in Chinese, we don't use to be, M is R. We say America very big. 美国很大. 很 is an adverb we use to modify the degree of that adjective we want to use. Check out this video to learn a list of most common adverbs as modifier for this kind of sentence. Let's try some more sentences. My Chinese is not very good. 我的中文不是很好. 不是很 is the modifier. His computer is a little expensive. 他的电脑有点贵. Mistake number 3, placing time and location at the end of the sentence. Time word or time term is usually placed before or after subject, but native speakers do prefer to put it after subject. For location, the form of expressing location is 在 plus a place. And this whole thing is usually placed before a verb in a sentence. I want to say, I cooked yesterday at home. In Chinese word order, it should be I yesterday at home cooked. 我昨天在家做了饭. Mistake number 4, placing time-related clauses at the end of the sentence. This so-called time-related sentence is usually connected by before, after, and when. And we consider this time-related clause as a time term, which means we place it after subject. I want to say, I will call you after I get home. In Chinese word order, it becomes I, after I get home, will call you. 我到家以后给你打电话. I like to tell my friend about my childhood story. I was naughty when I was in elementary school. In Chinese word order, it becomes I, when I was in elementary school, was naughty. 我上小学的时候很淘气. Mistake number 5, using 和 to connect sentences. 和 means and in Chinese, and we don't use 和 to connect sentences. For example, I want to say, my mom is a teacher and my dad is a police officer. It sounds so natural in English to use and to connect two sentences. But in Chinese, we say, 我妈妈是老师, comma, 我爸爸是警察. There's no 和 in the middle. We simply just use a comma to separate sentences. Then, how do we use 和? We use 和 to connect nouns and verb phrases. I can say, 我会说中文和英文. 中文 and 英文 are both nouns. I can also say, 我喜欢看电影和攀岩. 看电影 and 攀岩 are two verb phrases. And also, we don't use 和 to connect two adjectives. If I want to use two adjectives to describe my cat is cute and naughty. 我的猫很可爱，也很淘气. I didn't use and to connect two adjectives. Instead, I break it down into two sentences by using also. Yeah. We can also use the structure 요요 in a sentence to connect either two positive adjectives or two negative adjectives.
我的猫又可爱又淘气.
Mistake number 6. Always translating if as 如果. When if is an alternative to whether, we don't translate it into 如果. Instead, we use a not a structure. A represents a verb or adjective in a sentence. Let's try some sentences. I don't know if he speaks Chinese.
我不知道他会不会说中文.
He asked me if I'm a student.
他问我是不是学生.
I hope this video makes your Chinese learning a little bit easier. Please comment down below with a sentence where you avoid that specific mistake. Always remember, don't feel bad about making mistakes. It's part of learning and it can only help us improve and grow. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. I'll see you guys next time.
再见!